telling them that they have packed this gym. I can't believe we got to get extra chairs. First of all, I want to welcome everybody here and welcome all our Aston Coburn families here this evening. These boys and girls have worked really hard to prepare for this performance tonight. So let's give them a round of applause for some encouragement. School District School Board of Directors, as well as our Superintendent, Dr. Steinhoff, our Assistant Superintendent, Rick Gray. And of course, I want to thank Michael Stadnicki for building the foundation with our instrumental band students. So let's give Mr. Stadnicki a round of applause. Of course, I want to thank you all for making sure that they practice and get here early for those early morning practices and making sure that they are here and committed to learning their instrument. So without further ado, I'm gonna turn, well, first of all, I should say, my name is Eric Kamenka, the proud principal of Coburn Elementary. A lot of you don't know me, so I should introduce myself, so thank you. All right, and I'll turn over to Mr. Stadnicki and our instrumental band concert. We're gonna start off with the instrumental band, and then there'll be a short break, and we will shift over to our chorus group.
Have some notes this time. So, what I like to do, our first performance, I like to kind of just let you listen and enjoy what it is that we're performing. The second time, since it's a little bit more familiar, I like to talk about the things that we've worked on in each of these pieces. Now, sure enough, yes, we worked on notes and we worked on rhythms, but our first tune here, Sleigh Ride, has some slight fast rhythms that are going on. So you're gonna hear some of the woodwinds have crazy fingers going on as they move through quick notes. The first one is kind of a challenge because it's there's a difficult road map to it. Those of you who are musicians might be aware of repeat signs, but also tied with those can be first endings and second endings. So the first time they play through it, the second time they skip the first ending and go on to the second ending. That happens three times. So three times, not only can they easily get lost going from top to bottom, but they can easily get lost in, am I on the first time or am I on the second time? And where am I supposed to repeat back to? Am I going to that repeat or that repeat? Some other things about that, there's some extended ranges in the trumpets. They're playing some higher notes, and the flutes actually go down to some pretty low notes. We've also worked on some slurs, articulations, and this also has a lot of different accidentals, meaning flats, sharps, and naturals that we work on. And you also hear in our percussion section, we're going to have our slapstick, which is the sound of the horse whip. Unfortunately, we won't hear temple blocks tonight. She is sick, but I will make up a little bit of that on the keyboard. And then, of course, what kind of a sleigh ride would there be without the sleigh bells? So, please enjoy the sleigh ride.
Thank you.
introduction, but after that, when the actual jingle bell starts, there's a contrasting rhythm going on. So while the trumpets are playing jingle bells, everybody else is playing bells jingle, and it's so easy to kind of flip-flop and end up on the wrong rhythm. We also have some early entrances that happen here and there between the flutes and the trumpets. We've worked on some unison breathing, talked about breath marks that are added to our music. This also is a piece where the trumpets and the clarinets are not playing in unison with each other. There are two different parts on each of those. And we also have some extended range going on. Our clarinets and our saxophones go really deep into their basement with their low notes as they play the middle section as it's dashing through the snow. So this is our arrangement of Jingle Bells.
Thank you.
we're going to travel away from our traditional first key, which is B flat in concert band, and we're going to show you that we've learned how to play in the key of E flat, which is a totally different scale. With Trey Pack, it's pretty ridiculous what the clarinets and the flutes are doing at the beginning with their really fast rhythm, followed by that, we have some extended trumpet range. So again, they're in the stratosphere of their instrument. We talked about the difference between staccato markings and tenuto markings, which are they playing in a connected way or are they playing in a very separated way? We talked there is a low brass feature. There's not often times where the low brass get their own little melody, and to venture away from their do-so, but you'll hear them have their feature in the middle of this. And then also at the end, there's just a stream of quarter notes. It seems like unending quarter notes, where it's so easy for a young musician to get lost in all those quarter notes. So they're tracking, and they're reading their music fluently. In the drum section, the percussion section, we talked about eighth notes and eighth rests, which is pretty tricky as you start to think about eighth rests and putting rests on the beat and playing off of the beat. And you'll also hear some of the percussion instruments that you hear, which is pretty iconic for Trey Pack, and that's the tambourine, the triangle, and we actually have a timpani here. So please enjoy our arrangement of Trey Pack from the Nutcracker Suite. Before we play our last tune, we have two solos. We're going to have Brooke on the flute, who's going to play my dreidel, followed by Christian on the clarinet, who is going to play Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, a modified version of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Thank you. because great people can't be thanked enough. I must again, as I've done on Tuesday, thank our superintendent of schools, Dr. Steinhoff, our assistant superintendent of schools, Mr. Rick Brick, our school board of directors, both of my administrators, Mr. Eric Minka here at Coburn and Ms. Sue Phillips at Aston Elementary, the Department of Music, most especially Ms. Tally for everything that she does with early music education, where it's actually the most critical is grades pre-K through third is really, really instrumental to developing musicianship and aptitude that these students have on our stage here. I'd like to thank the Coburn faculty, especially my fourth and fifth grade colleagues who allow me to share their students with them and they understand the importance of music education. I'd like to thank our office secretaries, Ms. Kathy Savisky and Ms. Nayla Malkoots for everything that they do behind the scenes. Our custodians here, including our head custodian, Mr. John B., for everything that he does for us. You guys, the family, the community, I know that it takes a lot to get instruments here on stage, money-wise. Certainly, there's a lot of time that's invested, transportation to and from, getting your child to practice, even though we know they don't want to, but secretly they do. And your understanding of the value of music education and realizing that the skills that they are learning here and the development that is happening in their brains is going to be lifelong lasting. And I thank you for valuing and understanding the importance of studying an instrument. And then last but not least, our students here on stage, if it weren't for them, none of us would be here. If that's a good thing or bad, no, it's completely a good thing. So glad to have these students here. And I really do feel so fortunate to spend time with these students each week. Between the 20 minutes to 40 minutes, depending on the week. But I certainly look forward to seeing them each and every week. So thank you so much for allowing me to work with your student. Our last number is another one that's in the key of E-flat, so hopefully we get all of the concert A-flats going on in this one. I like it because it's an original composition. It's not an arrangement of something, even though it does include a traditional carol at the end. There's a lot of call and response that happens, especially between the clarinets and the trumpets, later on the flutes and the trombones. I picked this because I thought it was going to be easy. There's easy rhythms, there's easy notes. But when I started to work on it with the students, I kind of find out there's a lot of different layers. It's not just one or two things happening at the same time. It can be up to four and five different things happening at the same time. So putting all of that together, and as we say, staying on their own side of the road, made this one really, really tricky, trickier than I thought. There's a lot of contrasting articulations. The accompaniment playing staccato notes, short and separated, while the melody is playing nice legato connected lines. And then, if anything, probably the most difficult part about this is towards the end, we slow down. It might seem like an easy thing to do, but slowing down when you have 39 people at the same time doing the same thing, and then having a fermata at the end with three cued notes is pretty difficult. So, Thank you again for coming. After this, we'll have a brief intermission to the chorus. And so, without further ado, here is our Yuletide Spirit. Thank you.
education, and starting at the elementary level, and I had mentioned as well, we had a Coburn student make the Eastern Honors Ensemble, Jacqueline Sheck, and actually she was on this stage a few years ago, and I was honored to be at the Brookhaven Borough Council just the other night, seeing her get recognized within her town. So the foundation does begin here in the elementary level, and I want to give Ms. Talley a round of applause for building that foundation with our students musically. I want to thank Mr. Benzinger on piano for coming out tonight. And let's give these boys and girls one more round of applause of encouragement.
Thank you. The Hebrew word shalom means peace and harmony.
Thank you.
Christmas carol was originally a German carol in the early 1800s. It became so popular, it's now translated into over 140 languages around the world.
Slipping, sliding, everywhere rushing around.
All right, we have to give them one more round of applause. Thank you very much for Saturday. And boys and girls, let's give them your families a round of applause for supporting you tonight. All right, that concludes our holiday concert this evening. There are some refreshments over in the cafeteria. If you want to make your way over there, I'm sure the kids, not yet the kids. And we're going to meet the parents here. Okay, we're going to meet the parents right here so you can go over and collect your child. I'll leave you here overnight, please. Thank you. Have a great night.